Hola, how is everyone? I hope good. I am Sunny with Healing Power Divine Universe, and I am here with a reading on the person that loves you. How are they feeling about you? What are they thinking? What are they feeling? What are they looking at when it comes to you having a relationship with you or your relationship? What are they thinking and feeling? Before I get started, I ask if you hit that subscribe button, hit that bell notification so you're notified when I upload more videos, hit that like button, and share this video if you think others can benefit from your messages, or my messages, more like. Sorry. Or maybe from your messages, you know, you never know, or regarding your messages, whatever. Otherwise, let's get started here. First card I pulled is rebuild. Either they want to rebuild with you, they want to come together and build a love that is unbreakable, that creates this lightning that you see around this woman, around her heart. Maybe they're wanting to rebuild their life with you. Maybe their life was ripped apart by something, and they have chosen you to want to rebuild with. Maybe they're seeing you rebuilding after your heart being ripped out, and they're letting you have space and time to be able to do that, so then you can work through whatever you need to work through. They see you as having a lot of wisdom towards love, towards life. I think that you are the type of person that has gained a ton of wisdom from having your heart broken, and maybe they have too. Maybe you both are gaining wisdom on how a relationship should be, how you treat other people, what to expect from each other. Maybe they're wanting to get you pregnant because this woman has Earth, I think that's Earth, on her belly. They see that you're really connected to the divine. Maybe they might look at you like you're an angel because of the background on this card. Also, this woman in this card has wings. So maybe they look at you as you have really been through a lot in your life. You're trying to rebuild your life. And whatever you have gone through has really been an angel. Or maybe they look at you as an angel sent to them to help them rebuild their life in a more healthier, positive way. Sharing. They're wanting to share their love. They're wanting to share gifts with you. They're wanting to share their love. I think I already said that. They're wanting to share their wealth if they're wealthy. They're wanting to share everything with you. They look at you like this woman on this card, that you really share a lot with the world and that you deserve to have as much given back to you as you give to other people. And they're wanting to be the person that does that, which is absolutely beautiful. If you can really meet somebody that can really know who you are from the inside out and really appreciate what you do, how you treat other people, how you treat yourself, even how you treat them. And then they also look at you, I didn't mean to interrupt that conversation, but they look at you as that light on that candle. Like you're lighting the way to more success, more happiness, being able to share with somebody that will actually appreciate what they share with them. Because maybe they were in something that they didn't, or with someone that didn't appreciate it. We have trust, so they really do trust you. I accept that my inner voice will always guide me correctly. They're trusting their inner voice when it comes to you. Their inner voice is telling them who you are, what you're about. Maybe this person has heard bad things about you. Maybe they know of things that have happened in your life that have really been pretty dramatic, I'm hearing. But they're, and it might have kind of scared them away. But I think that they're seeing you as a person that's rebuilding from all the things that you've gone through. And you've really allowed yourself to gain a lot of wisdom through all the journeys that you've been through. And they're trusting their inner voice because I feel like spirit himself, maybe your angels, your guides, your ancestors are wanting this love to come together. I kind of feel that this person or you were I believe that you two were sent to each other to help one another in different ways, but to definitely be able to rebuild your heart and to share the wisdom that you both have gained throughout all your experiences in life. But they're wanting a relationship because you received a relationship card. I call in the infinite power of love to take over this union in every way. May it now fully belong to the divine. Let it unfold in the perfect way for each of us. I needn't fear letting go of control. My needs are always abundantly met. So they feel like their needs and with you would be met, that this relationship would really fulfill them. And I think that they feel like they could fulfill you also. Maybe they have doubts, but they're really wanting the divine to guide you together if this relationship's meant to be. We have the Four of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. The Four of Wands represents stability, holidays, marriage plans. Now, this is in reverse, so maybe they're doubting that you could have the stability together. Maybe that's what's holding this relationship up. Maybe they're afraid to approach you with this offer because they fear that you're going to reject them. But their inner voice is telling them to go for it. But I have a feeling that they're kind of teetering, like these spiders or whatever the fuck they are on here. Scared to approach you. But I feel that they're wanting to have a relationship with you that's going to eventually, hopefully, they hope, go into maybe even marriage. Even though this card's in reverse, I think that they're scared to offer you this. I get a feeling that there's something more going on with this. Maybe this person you don't know very well. Maybe this person really knows a lot about you because they've been watching you. And I don't mean like in a creepy way. Maybe they watched you for their work. I don't know. We have the King of Cups, understanding. The King of Cups have been coming out in every one of my readings. I feel that this is the king that wants to offer you this relationship, the stability, the marriage plans. Again, the king always has a cup with him. This person might drink a lot, or this person might be drinking because they're not understanding this connection. Maybe they're not understanding what's drawing them to you so deeply. Maybe this person has been covering up their emotions for you with alcohol. They're wanting to offer you this cup of love, but they first have to understand what this union is, what this relationship is, why they feel so drawn to you, why they feel so just... You know, I mean, maybe they feel love towards you. Maybe you just met. Again, I feel more that this person knows a lot about you and about your life. And really sees the journey that you've been on. So maybe you are connected, you know, telepathically. I don't know. We'll see. We have the Death card in reverse. So the Death card is sign of Scorpio, so they could be a Scorpio, but this is a rebirth. This is, you know, having a renewal, a rebirth after a death of something. Maybe they're afraid, or maybe this person hasn't gone through the rebirth yet, or they're afraid you haven't. Or you haven't let go of a death situation. Maybe you lost somebody really close to you in death. And maybe they fear that you long for that person. And maybe because maybe it was like somebody that you were in love with in on a romantic sense. Maybe there's a death that has to do with this situation. Maybe this person has been watching you and observing you because of a death. I don't know. I keep saying I don't know. We have the Knight of Coins in reverse. This is Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This is a eventual positive outcome. This is a reliable young man. This card's in reverse. So I feel that they're worried that there will not be a positive outcome to this situation. There's something that happened. And they're trying to really trust their inner voice about this relationship. But they're having serious doubts. Maybe you two people are you. I'm sorry, my dog keeps whining, keeps interrupting me. Maybe you are two different people. You come from two walks of life. Maybe one of you are religious and the religion doesn't, recognize spirituality. Maybe they think spirituality is evil. A lot of religions do. Whatever, more power to them. I feel that religions are evil, but that's my personal opinion. And I feel like I can say that on here because I don't think very many religious people watch my channel. And if they do, it's to probably mock me and try and say that I'm evil and whatever else they fucking want to say, which I don't care. And if that's your energy, get the fuck off my channel because all you do is bring that darkness into my channel and I just don't appreciate it and I don't want it here. And I ask, the higher power to protect us from shit like that. Or if you're jealous or envious or anything like that, just know that you're just creating tons of karma for yourself. Your angels are wanting you to look for the signs, both of you. Look for the signs that are being shown. Because we receive signs from our angels or guides or ancestors and source in so many ways. And they are really sending you the signs, so you both need to be paying attention to what they're trying to tell you. Somebody in this situation is feeling helpless and hopeless. They're feeling like this isn't going to come together because of something. Something might have happened. Maybe you were getting to know this person and something triggered you or triggered this person to kind of step back and really look for the signs if this is really the relationship that you want to have. Maybe there are so many differences that it's scaring somebody. Or maybe there's a third party situation, even though that card hasn't came out, that is really putting up a wall between you at this time. I mean, there could be so many scenarios. They are wanting to have growth with you. They do see your growth. I think that you have grown with wisdom and with love and trust throughout whatever you have gone through in your life. Maybe it wasn't bad. Maybe it was. But they're definitely wanting to plant seeds and have growth with you and have a future with you. This is how they feel. Maybe you're not communicating with them very much. Maybe you have stepped back to really view what the situation is. Maybe there's been a red flag that has really hindered the growth of this relationship coming together. Maybe you're not having any communication with them at all. But they feel like they're in the dark of what to do, how what to expect. I think this person really does want something with you. I do think that they have deep feelings for you, which I think scares you because I think you can feel their energy. But I think it also scares them because they're not sure why they're so drawn to you. Someone here feels like a failure, or they feel like this relationship so far has been a failure. I understand that a mistake is only an opportunity to learn. So somebody here made a mistake, did something that really threw this relationship off ki like kilter, I think that's how you say it, that really knocked it into this no thingness. And I really think that you need to communicate with each other if you're wanting this to go any further. Self-love. Show me how to love myself. Show me how to take care of the inner child. Show me how to be kind within. When you step into self-forgiveness, so much can change on the outside. So more self-love is needed from both of you. Maybe you both are insecure about this. Maybe you're scared that you're going to step into a relationship that is really going to be like your past, and spirit's really wanting you to put that in the past. To really allow yourself to step into this to see what it's all about without fear. To really have enough self-love to know that you're good enough for each other. We have the Five of Cups, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. The Five of Cups represents feelings of disappointment, letdown, even betrayal or regret. So maybe somebody did let somebody down in this situation. Maybe there was a betrayal that really tore this apart. But there is regret on somebody's part. And if that's on your part or on theirs, whomever's, you need to release that because it's hindering the growth in this relationship. Forgiveness is needed, self-love, moving out of this no-thingness, this darkness, and communicating how you're feeling about one another would probably be the first step I would recommend, and I'm sure Spirit would too. We have Ten of Pentacles, luck. So they feel like they're very lucky to have you in their life. And I don't think it really, and this is Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, by the way. I don't think it really is because of financial means. It could. One of you could be really rich. And one of you might end up very lucky because if you bring this together, you both will be financially abundant. Maybe you'll create this financial abundance together. But I think it's more that, someone here or both of you feel very lucky to have met the other person. And it's really that, what are they feeling about you? What is the love that they're feeling? What are they wanting? And they're feeling very lucky to have met you. We have the Devil in reverse. The sign of Capricorn. Devil in reverse, this is when we are doing something too much of. If it's too much sex, if it is overthinking about this relationship, if it is addictions, maybe both of you are ridding something out of your life, unbinding yourself to this devil like these naked people on this picture. Maybe somebody's a sex addict here. Maybe somebody's addicted to sex because these people are naked on here. And maybe it's a hard thing to do. But the devil was present in this relationship, but with it being in reverse, the devil's being removed. Or maybe at first, this person just looked at you like a piece of meat, like somebody to just to fuck and walk away from. Or maybe you did. But I think that they truly got to know you throughout whatever experience or whatever happened in this situation. And they no longer see you as just a sex object. Maybe you're fucking sexy. Maybe you're beautiful. Maybe you're handsome. And at first sight, maybe that's what people do, is they have just sexual fantasies about you. But maybe the connection with you and the other person is so much deeper than just sex. Maybe that's what they're trying to say. Maybe somebody here is worried that it's just about sex. And in true light, it's way more than just sex because this card's in reverse. Or maybe somebody's having trouble performing sexually, not because they're not attracted to the other person. Maybe it's because of an addiction. Maybe somebody does too many drugs and they have trouble performing, or they drink too much. Since the King of Cups comes out, maybe this person needs you to understand more. I don't know. But it's something to do with sex. Queen of Coins. I keep saying I don't know. I'm sorry. I never usually do that in my reading. But, just take a shot for every time I say, I don't know. I don't know. Queen of Coins, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This woman knows her worth. She's capable and practical of taking care of herself. Maybe this is a woman that, or this is a man that is feeling this way towards a woman. And maybe they feel like this woman is more than capable and practical of taking care of herself. And they've never been around a woman like that, so it really intimidates them. Within the next few weeks, your angels want you to know this will come together, maybe even stronger in the next few weeks, or the communication will come in. Or this person will come and, well, communicate with you, tell you how they're feeling. There's going to be a new vitality in it. See all that beautiful color? Something happened to stop this relationship. If it was a mistake somebody made, or a red flag that came up, or somebody is leaving somebody in the dark because they're trying to see or feel what they're feeling, or try to decide if this is really where they want to go. I think within the next few weeks, this will come back together. Somebody's not wanting somebody to see what's really going on with them. Impasse is like when you don't want somebody to really see what's behind this guy. Or again, you might not think this person knows, but they do. I don't know why I'm getting that. It's like they already know what's, and there's confirmation. That's what I'm feeling. Even if you don't even know this person, you might have just met this person, but this person knows all about you. Somehow they had a peek within your life. They were able to peek in and see what you've been through, what you might be hiding, or maybe it's vice versa. But they know that your life has been far from perfect. We have suppression in reverse. Somebody was suppressing their emotions or feelings, but with this card being in reverse, they're about ready to communicate how they're feeling because they no longer want to feel like this person on this card. Honesty. See, I'm good. I can't help it, but I'm good. I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it for myself. This person is going to come be honest with you. They not only look at you as a very honest person, you might be a little bit outspoken. You might just lay shit on the line. You might be, some people might just find you to be too blunt. You like honesty. I think that because you have been through so much in your life and people have been so dishonest with you throughout your life that you're not going to accept anything less but than honesty. And I think this person knows it. And I think this person is moving out of the suppressing of their feelings because it was in reverse, and they're going to come straight towards you and be honest. Sanctuary. A sanctuary resides inside you no matter what is happening. This inner temple beckons you to enter. Take a deep breath, enter, and sit down on the throne of your own heart. That's what they want to do because you are such a loving person. They want to come in and sit on the throne of your heart. They want you to love them. They want to love you. They know that you are their inner temple. This person knows that you're their person. Even if they haven't expressed it, even if they're trying to mask it with addictions, with the devil, whatever it is. But the truth is going to come out within the next couple weeks because this person's not going to be able to hold it back. Because this person has been suppressing their feelings for you for a long time, I'm telling you. Knight of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This knight is, an eventual positive outcome, and this is a reliable young man. So we already received this card in a different deck, but it was in reverse. And they finally know, I think, or after this person stops suppressing their emotions, they come be honest with you. You are going to have that positive outcome with this person. Five of Swords, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, conflict. So maybe you are in conflict with this person. over something. Something happened here. I don't think it's like fussing and fighting, though. I think it's just something that you might have had a disagreement about, and it really knocked whatever was happening here. Really made this person suppress their emotions. Really made them fearful to come offer you love. But with this coming out, and then the sun coming out right after it, that conflict's going away. Because this is the most positive card in the deck. We all know that. Even if it's in reverse. And they know that you are the sun. They know that you are that flower. They know that you are their pure light and love and happiness. And this person isn't going to let that go. No way. You both might be in hermit mode thinking about this. This could be a sign of Virgo. But you see this big light here? This light is pushing and leading this person to you, straight towards you. Straight towards offering you a very positive outcome. Very healthy relationship. There's just something that is holding it back at this time. And the last card is Be Observant. Do we already have that card? No, Look for Signs, but that's pretty much the same. You need to be very observant because this person's trying to tell you, trying to let you know how much they really do love you, how much they really are into you, but you're missing the signs. There's confirmation. Maybe this person is trying to reach out to you and you're not reaching out to them. Maybe they're asking you questions and you're kind of ignoring them. I think that you need to step up to the plate and really go forward if this is what you want. Because this person really wants this happy ending with you. That's all I have for this reading. I hope it resonated with you. If it didn't, check out one of my other videos. I love you all so very much. Have a beautiful, loving day. Peace.